Dr. Kakodkar, Professor Bhatkar, all the panelists from the TIFAC Education Group, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, I have a disadvantage of not being associated with the TIFAC report, which I can say that it is an advantage for me while talking. These presenters have really raised challenges before us. And when we consider these challenges technologically and educationally, I was trying to think about the challenge which education was having since ages. An educational challenge at one time was how to find out two forms of thinking, dvaya, or duality in thinking, and united action, unity in action, or advaita in action. This might appear to be philosophical. In fact, all the initial development in education is mostly by philosophers. And the dvaya advaya or dvaita advaita aspect is really very basic to education, though it has vanished in our education. Why it is like that? Because when problems were raised, I was all the time feeling that are we not going off the line? Off the line in the sense that education deals with human action. Human action deals with brain action as well as body action. Brain action is entirely in the artificial space or brain space. And body action is in real space. So the brain action in virtual space, which is like a black box, and my body action in my real space, if I do not link it two together, somewhere I'm deficient. And what is the dvaya, advaya? I'm coming from the Indian point of view. Dvaya, advaya, well, duality in quantum theory can be imagined and everybody knows about it. But dvaya is a development of human being from his irrational and impulsive animal behavior to a rational thinking type of development of a human being. And if this rationality is considered as the basic, then irrationality or impulsiveness in our behavior appears to be something derogatory or pulling us back from humanistic approach. So, to put it bluntly, we have both animal actions and human actions, which should dominate in our activities. And there is also third aspect, which comes in the form of imagination. So if one thinks of a mind, if one thinks of a self, if one thinks of will, these are the concepts which need to be defined in modern terms now. Self, I think here J. Krishnamurti is a really a good philosopher and thinker, because he defines it only in terms of facts, which are the reality. Anything of the type of an idea or a model, he said that has it been observed in nature, it is all okay. If it is not observed in nature, that means it is imagination. So leave it aside for the time being. So that is the approach taken at one time But the basic process of humanization is from the animal nature to the human nature, which has required nearly 100,000 years. And this long process of biological evolution is still going on, but it is a very slow process. But the other process is a process of psychological revolution, which has come in during the last 10,000 years. The speakers have already mentioned it, that we have moved from three or four ages, tribal age, agrarian age, industrial age, and now digital age. And each one is having a technological build-up, which becomes a part of educational communication factor. So if one looks at it from that point of view, I think the progress is from thoughtless action, impulsive action, to thoughtful action and imaginative action added to it. And that's how the mind is defined by J. Krishnamurti, a totality of thoughtful action, impulsive or irrational action, and imaginative action. And if will and self are defined, these days educationists know the self-development aspect. And self-development goes from fulfillment of physiological needs, fulfillment of social needs, now fulfillment of rational needs, and knowing the digital technology and application of it in modern times. And the last one is self-actualization work. Now, if this is the path of self, corresponding movement generates what is known as will or force of will. So you have a needs fulfillment as a requirement. You have a will force which generates motivation, and you add a mind to it, and you get various states of your mind definition or mind states. Now, are we not considering that part of mind? And in some cases, I think this point was mentioned, that here human touch is more important. But which are the sectors in which human touch is absolutely essential? And which are the sectors where the routineness is there, where technology can be taken over? Technology can take over. I think such sort of a approach will be far more easier. And this has been developed by our philosophers. Gandhiji developed it in his Nayi Talim and called it Samavaya. Samavaya is how to balance between your thoughtfulness and thoughtlessness, between the two. And whatever the action you do it is a mix of the two. But then make it purely thoughtful action, having some sort of imagination. And then that Samavaya became a part of the Nayi Talim. Can we use the same sort of principle, Dvaya Advaya? And understanding Dvaya in everybody's life and personality, and take that as a part of education, mind training, mind education, and make it a central part of personal development. Now, it's a good thing that, well, the technology of 2035 we are speaking, and it's sure that advanced robotics, then smartphones, cloud support, universal connectedness, all these factors are going to add to our comfort and life in rather next 20 years. And next 20 years is supposed to be fourth industrial revolution aspect. And if that is the revolution aspect, then this revolution first can solve the problems of living. Problems of rather basic needs, social needs. And once the basic needs and social needs problems are solved by the society and technology, then our future becomes a completely different one. So in a way, rather, I'm telling you the model which our Indian thinkers have thought about, but I believe that it can always be put into the digital technology format, where the digital technology offers you cyberspace as a part of your real space. And cyberspace, one can have a movement of your mind and intelligence. And real space, it is only the body movement. And combining these two becomes a model of education, which is more closer to the Indian thought of Dvaya Advaya education. I think I wanted to rather raise you this point because I was not knowing what is rather here. And I thought that, well, possibly I can tell that there is also another model of educating your mind and making psychology as a main part of rather mind education, because that is a revolutionary change now which is bringing it about. Simultaneously, technology can do subversive acts, no doubt. It has done already in a number of cases. But this is not subversion. Revolution does bring subversion. Evolution never brings any subversion. It is a slow transformation. And now how to make it a slow transformation in every individual from the existing situation to a better and better situation where my mind problems are solved and I have a peaceful way of living and doing. And also my the livelihood problems and local problems of development are solved, in which I can combine these actions with village development or might be village development or the developmental aspects in the 21st century society. I think I will not go much in details, but that is the basis of the educational model which we are trying to evolve. It has already been evolved, and we are going to implement it from this month onwards. I think that's why I thought that I should talk about it. But one point is, type of models you are talking about, they are no doubt more from the technological aspect. Can we see it from human aspect and human-centric aspect? And ultimately, my path of life and path of life concept is not rather mine. It has been stated by Gautam Buddha. And how to find out one's own path of life, and he was suggesting path of life, but path of mukti is to be found out by everybody, because that is a different aspect of your mind. The same thing has to come in our education now. What is your path of life which you are developing? Learning path, development path, career path, transformative path. One can always think it. And therefore, I thought that there is an alternative model possible which can be married with the technological development appropriately. And I'm not saying that, well, there is a contradiction. No. No contradiction. But it can be proper union of these two. And let me stop it here. I've taken a little longer time. Sorry. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.